I'm Ben Meyer.
And I'm Rob Wright.
And this week we're going to do a follow-up to last week's show, Super Sequels. This is a super sequel of the super sequels.
I don't know if it'll be better than the original, but it's... It's a sequel to these super sequels.
Shoot for the stars, man.
Yeah. Aim high.
Aim high. Anyway, yeah. There was a lot of categories. We got some good feedback. There was a lot of categories we didn't cover, so we're just adding genres here.
Yes.
And no revisions, but we're adding on.
No, more categories, more genres.
So, Rob, we have a number of rules. So
ground rules.
Let them know the rules for those who didn't watch.
For our lists, for our sequels, we're not going to do annual sports games, annual racing game editions, music game editions. They're kind of all the same thing to me. No spiritual successors. No expansion packs, no spin-offs or reboots or, sort of franchise titles that have the same license but aren't really the same game. You know what I mean. And lastly,
no Sims.
No Sims.
Because we don't want to do them. Okay. Now, first up, we're doing the platformer.
Yes.
And there's kind of a big dog in the kitchen.
Yes.
With this one. N64, Super Mario 64, a launch title. Best-selling game. I think we had this on some all-time lists of ours. Took Mario from the 2D to the 3D world.
Amazing.
Just rocked it. Such a fun game. Probably my favorite, a lot of people's favorite Mario game. And that's saying a lot. Super Mario Brothers I played. It had a certain layer of complexity, but still had all the fun and characters of the original. And I don't know what else to say. I mean, if you haven't played that game, I mean, I don't know what to say to you.
The amount of time that it took to develop that game is pretty...
Oh, it's incredible.
Yeah.
They did it under 2 years.
Under 2 years.
Think about game development now. Under 2 years?
But a complete overhaul of the series, you know. I mean, a lot of people would say that Super Mario Bros. 3 is as good as the 64 version. You know, there are other good platformers out there. So obviously, Sonic has a couple of really great sequels.
Yeah.
Castlevania Symphony of the Night is also outstanding, but Super Mario 64.
Just...
Gotta go with that. Next up... Multiplayer shooters. Now, for this genre, we're talking games that, you know, not first-person shooters that have a multiplayer component, because, let's face it, they all do. But games that are primarily or almost exclusively multiplayer in nature. So for that, you know, there's games out there that Unreal Tournament has a couple of excellent sequels. And those are good, but I think when you talk about better than the original, you got to go with one game. It's my passion, it's my obsession, quite frankly, since I played so much in the office, Team Fortress 2.
Great.
I don't know how you can go with anything else. Or at least, I don't know how I can go with anything else. I know some people might argue that Unreal 2004 is better, but, you know, what they did, what Valve did with Team Fortress 2, just, you know, completely different than the first game, the Team Fortress Classic. The cartoonish kind of animation that they brought in there, the kill cam, the different classes, so much fun. So, you know, the distinct characters, great stuff.
Yeah.
Fantastic. And they're still working on it. I mean, they're still releasing updates, new maps.
Yeah, no, they've really kept the buzz going in this game, which has
been
really impressive.
New achievements, unlockable weapons, great. Fantastic, love it.
That's obviously, definitely probably played more around here than any other
title.
And we're almost a year in now, right?
I'm obsessed. What am I going to tell you?
Well, the next category is action-adventure, and, there's a lot of titles in this one,
yeah,
too. A lot, you know, in previous generations. But another one we kind of had to go with. Nintendo again.
Yeah.
N64 again.
Yep.
Zelda, Ocarina of Time. Developed in conjunction with Super Mario 64, incidentally.
Yeah.
But released a couple of years later, and again, took the 2D... top-down Zelda world, made it 3D, kept the puzzle elements, great music, musical puzzles and stuff in that game.
Yeah.
A lot put into a package.
Yeah.
And made it work.
And it's crazy because I'm not a big Zelda fan, but when I played that game, I was pretty much floored. Beautiful visuals and the story. I think it's one of the best game stories around, certainly the best Zelda story.
Yeah.
It's fantastic. It really is. I mean, there are other good games.
Yeah. I mean, Super Metroid's great. Tomb Raider series. A lot of people love Lara Croft.
But let's be honest. Ocarina of Time is one of the... It's probably one of the five greatest games, according to a lot of people's lists, ever made. So,
yeah.
You got to go with that. Next up, turn-based strategy. Now, we did real-time strategy in the last episode, and all apologies to the people that were upset that I chose Warcraft 3 over Age of Empires 2. I do apologize, even though I stand by the decision. Turn-based strategy, crowded category.
Yes.
Heroes of Might and Magic 2, XCOM 2, Terrors from the Deep, Galactic Civilizations 2. I mean, there's a lot of good turn-based strategy. It's a genre that, you know, maybe doesn't get recognized as much these days because of real-time strategy, but a lot of good games, but there's really only one. It is considered one of the greatest PC games of all time. It's Civilization 2.
Civ 2.
I mean, Civ was good.
Yeah, I vaguely remember playing it.
It was good, but Civilization 2 had better AI. It had more unique units. The wonders and the technologies that they introduced in that game just made it so much more fun. And just the way they changed the view and the visuals really made it more enticing for someone like myself who didn't really get into Civilization 1 that much. Just a fantastic game, and people still play it today.
Yeah.
It's a great game.
That's always the mark. I feel like a lot of these titles came in that age where they were taking things and going from 2D to 3D.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, in the 90s. And
so that golden age.
That golden age for sequels. And another one, this came out a little bit later, but same idea, in the MMO category. And this is a tough category because, you know, the business model is different, so they don't want to come out with sequels. They just want to give expansion packs and, you know, keep you paying for the same deal. But there were a couple.
Yeah, there were a few.
You know, Ashran's Call 2 came to mind. But our choice was Lineage 2.
Yeah.
Lineage 2 came out in about 2003. Huge leap graphically over Lineage. Very popular, especially in Korea. Used the Unreal 2 engine.
More popular than the original, I think, now at this point.
Yeah, sure. You know, it just did Lineage better. I mean, it was a classic super sequel in that regard.
Yeah.
But,
yeah.
You know, obviously this category isn't really built around sequels. So
no,
it's
kind of a weird one. City of Heroes had City of Villains, but City of Villains isn't really a sequel. It's more of an expansion. It's a lot of expansions in that category, but, you know, a couple of good sequels. So, last category. This one's been looming since the last show. I wanted to do it in the first episode, but I couldn't come to a decision.
Yeah.
I agonized over it. I passed the buck, quite frankly, because I didn't want to decide on it. I agonized over it.
He really does agonize. It's
probably safe to say that I beat myself up a little bit, like Edward Norton-style Fight Club, over this decision because it was so hard. Space Sim is the genre. A lot of good Space Sim titles. We forget how good these Space Sims were in the heyday on the PC in the 90s. You had Wing Commander 2. You had X3. There's just so many Space Sims that were just great. But really what it came down to for me was Star Wars TIE Fighter and Free Space 2. And I tossed and I turned, and I didn't know what to do. And I finally came to a decision, and I went with Free Space 2.
Free Space, which is interesting from a big Star Wars guy like yourself.
I'm a huge Star Wars. TIE Fighter is probably my favorite Star Wars game. Well, Knights of the Old Republic, but you get the point. But Free Space 2, it's in that pivotal time during the 90s when, you know, games were kind of maturing, evolving. And this game comes along and it introduces, you know, a few years later, and it comes along, amazing combat, amazing kind of just dynamic space sim combat, epic scale, fantastic sound, which we take for granted in today's sort of modern era. Just epic presentation and, you know, great mods. There's so many mods for this game.
Yeah.
There's really two popular mods, Battlestar Galactica, Babylon 5. I mean, it just really, it brought space sim combat up to the level that we see today. And sadly, you know, the game didn't really sell well, and it people say that that's the last great space.
So why do you think that hasn't been a popular genre?
I just think that, you know, with the shooters and other games kind of becoming more advanced, I think that it's kind of overshadowed that genre, and people aren't in space sims as much. And it's sad because, you know, this game is great, and it's not that old. I mean, it's less than 10 years old, I think. So I mean, it's you got to go out there and try it. It's great.
A lot
it's
of fantastic. Fun. I'm sure you could pick it up.
Yeah.
Pretty cheap. But that's all the time we have for this week. I'm Ben Meyer.
And I'm Rob Wright.
And we'll see you next time. And what was Castlevania Symphony of the Night?
That was PlayStation. Oh. That was like when the series moved off Nintendo, because I don't think the N64 had a Castlevania game.
You know, I never loved Castlevania.
You're crazy. The original Castlevania is one of the greatest games.
I was weird with games. Like, I didn't love Contra either. Like Contra and Castlevania.
Now you're out your damn mind.